regard any nuclear missiles, launching of Cuba against any nations in the Western Hemisphere, as an attack by the Soviet Union or the United States.
The U.S. makes clear that the missile bases must be dismantled and begins a massive buildup. The Strategic Air Command and U.S. forces around the world are put on emergency alert.
The world awaits the outcome.
Russian leader says his country will halt shipments of offensive equipment to Cuba. Also will dismantle and take back all missiles in place or under construction there.
East, people, west, as a handshake bridges 16,000 miles and 22 years of hostility.
The United States will meet with superpowers and seek to relax tension.
We make no secret that we see detente as the way to create more favorable conditions for the communist construction.
The Soviet army outnumbers ours more than 2-1. Their strategic nuclear missiles are larger, more powerful, and more numerous than ours. The evidence mounts that we are number two in a world where it's dangerous, if not fatal, to be second best.
The Soviet Union is moving to solidify control in neighboring Afghanistan.
Their largest pure force since the communist invasion of Czechoslovakia. 11,000 soldiers to the top of America.
If they maintain their dominance over Afghanistan, and then extend their control to adjacent countries, the stable, strategic, and peaceful balance of the entire world will be changed.
As for the enemies of freedom, those who are potential adversaries, they will be reminded that peace is the highest aspiration of the American people. We will negotiate for it, sacrifice for it. We will not surrender for it now or ever.